When you walk my way with your pepper spray, all I can do is watch your hips sway. So come on now, police woman in your blue uniform, let me turn you on. Harass me, harass me, harass me. Police woman, don't you know that I will turn you on with your own baton. I will turn you on with your handcuffs on. Come on, policewoman in your blue uniform, let me turn you on. Can do is watch your hips sway when you walk my way, police woman.
Please talk. Can someone talk to me? Can someone actually just tell me where the US Embassy staff are? So the British High Commission are not answering the door to two British citizens wanting to ask questions. Pretty shoddy. And it's raining now. Third venue today.
Well, just a bogus red herring. The US Constitution protects publishers and journalists and whistleblowers, but his crime was just to have broken the silence. It provided, shown that we're complicit by failing to speak out against illegal wars and the attacks on this journalist who's actually provided the real truth and the deceit of Western governments. There's no investigative journalism in our lifetime who's equal importance in terms of information he has provided through Wikileaks. He's called rapacious power to account. He's shown that our governments are supporting 70% of the military dictatorships around the world, including Saudi Arabia, which has an appalling record in terms of human rights and the treatment of women, but also is attacking on behalf of United States Yemen. And we know that millions of people are a threat now in Yemen of starvation because they're closing the last port there, which is providing the humanitarian aid. At the same time, the drone execution that we don't really hear of innocent people all through the Middle East and any part of the world. Malcolm Turnbull can remain silent, or he can seize this opportunity and use his government's diplomatic influence to defend the life of an Australian citizen, a really top Australian citizen, whose courageous public service is recognised by countless people across the world. He can bring Julian Assange home, and that's what we ask him to do right now.
Right, we're gonna take it away now. Bye bye, beehive, until the next time. This will be where we come for emergency action. There's been a few people walking past today and taking an interest, which is great. It's just what we want. Some people are like, who's Julian? That astounds me, really, but anyway. Some people are like, we're with her. And I think those people really need to do some more investigation. But anyway, here we are. Free speech, freedom of press. Not 1984, if we can help it.